Howdy. Welcome to our first mission in the Pacific Ocean. Here we're looking at the three islands, or three of the seven or nine Hawaiian islands. I forgot. I think there's seven islands. There could be nine, there could be more. Anyway, we're looking at the Oahu Island. We'll be taking off from the Haleiwa field, which is on the northwestern corner. We're flying down to Pearl Harbor, which is a south central part of Oahu. So your squadron commanding officer is Major Billick, December 7th, 1941. It's a very important date that we'll find out. 0800, weather is clear, clouds at 4,500 feet. Air raid on Pearl Harbor, this is not drill. Flight officer over here will fly on Major Billick's wing. So December 7th, 1941, that's the date that we're living in for me. We're about to relive that in this mission. So we're flying a P-40B, which is a Tomahawk. It's pretty much outdated by this time. And, hold on. I think I forgot to plug in my track IR. Here we go. Yeah, I have a opening canopy. So my internal lights on, external lights on. Here's the throttle, as always. And then below it is the propeller pitch. Turn it all the way up to 100. And I think down somewhere. Oh, it's a radiator control. Turn it down to open. I don't have a fuel mixer control. I don't have a start of the engine. I don't have a supercharger control. Do I have flaps that I can't see? Is my wing leader taking off? So I have the instruments. They are in knots and feet per second or miles per hour. But I'm used to flying with the kilometers per hour, so I have the speed bar turned on. So I'm gonna slowly rev up my engine, see which way it pulls. Plane pulls to the left, so I have to use the rudder right to stay on the runway here, and then once I get used to it, I'll rev up all the way. Takeoff speed is 165 kilometers per hour. I'm going 110 right now. 130, 150, pulling up now. I'm off the air. I'm off the ground, I mean, by 160 kilometers per hour. And it's my plane. Raising up my gears. I have three wheels, two in the front, one in the back. They all went in. Raise up my flaps. I can turn off my navigation lights, my internal lights. This is a very different view outside than the snowy Russia that we're used to. The water's a little bluer, the trees are a little greener.
Heading 150, altitude 10.
So I'm still flying with my cockpit, my canopy open. We'll hear a lot of winds, but I like the fresh air. Take a look at my guns here. And I don't have a good view behind me. Can't see my rudder pedals, or my rudder controls. Nice view out there. The weather's gorgeous. So P-40s are pretty much outdated by this time. The end of 1941. As far as the warplanes are concerned, but yet it was still the best chance the U.S. had against the enemies. So the U.S. stocked up on it. It's like a big, heavy, clumsy machine that let's go straight, and it's good at going straight, it's good at shooting, it's good at taking damage, it's good at diving down, but it's not good at anything else. Just think of it like a big American muscle car, you know. It goes straight, it goes, you know, once it picks up speed, it will go fast, and, you know, nothing will stop it. But it will not accelerate fast, it will not decelerate well, it will not turn well. Just does not handle well, and as far as this airplane is concerned, it does not climb well. That's what it all comes down to. So it's a kind of outdated plane, but they don't have planes that are much better than this. Anyway, so what happened here is this airplane is sitting out. The row, another row, it's a big 4x4 pile of airplanes out there. So US generals at this time in Hawaii were afraid of the let's climb up a bit. There were the generals are afraid of the sabotage. They're afraid of the spies sneaking in to the hangars and sneaking in the middle of the night and spying on these planes and snapping some wires and planting some bombs and whatnot. So they had all these planes taken out from the hangars and put them in the public view, so no one could do anything with the planes without being caught. But what the Japanese did was they came with a full force. They came with bombers. They came with the bombers and fighters and dive bombers, torpedo bombers, and submarines. And when that happens, you want your assets and planes hidden. They want, you want your stuff hidden in the hangars, so the enemy will have to guess where anything is. But no, that's not the case. You have planes in the wide open, the field view in the public, all lined up, and all in, you know, all formations, and you know, all the important stuff taken out, you know, emptied out, and you know, just out there, the sunbathing. And the bombers came and just drop a bomb in the middle of a big pile of the planes, and you know, they get all the planes with one bomb, and the strafers, they just hold on the triggers.
11 o'clock. What the hell? Stay with your leader. Heading
I'm with you, man.
300. Altitude 15.
I don't see any bombers at 11 o'clock. But over there is the Pearl Harbor. It's the Ford Island. This whole bay area is the Pearl Harbor. Oh look, A6M, those are not bombers, those are fighters, so surely they're the escorts to the bombers that are yet invisible to me. So here a lot of winds. So right here, much wind. There goes my guy, the crazy, crazy Billy guy. So when the Japanese came, you know, there's no guesswork, just drop the bombs, strafed all the planes in line, and then they have a visual confirmation of the kills, and they just went back without much resistance, because all the planes were sunbathing. They weren't fit to fly, they weren't fit to scramble, they weren't fit to defend themselves. This was a old P-3A, those are dive bombers.
Attention, forward, 1 o'clock.
Yeah, well, yeah. Let's take one pass at these A6M, the Japanese Zeros, and then we'll go take a closer look at those dive bombers. This guy's got on kill. So we have relatively good guns and armors, but so they can outturn us. If I turn like that, my plane will just croak and die. It will just turn over. Make really big turns, big wide turns. Very slowly.
Stay with your leader. Stay on course. Heading 330.
Set on fire.
15. What the hell? Attention, forward. 4 o'clock.
I don't want to stray too far from Pearl Harbor. Shit.
This one,
driver,
here we go.
Attack and bandit. As you can see, I can't really see behind me. Don't have a mirror either. It's a Japanese plane compared to mine. A relatively lighter. They're quicker, in the sense that they can accelerate fast and climb fast. My guy's getting me.
Heading
but in order to do that, to
zero.
Make their planes lighter, they lack an armor.
Over. What the hell? Stay with your leader.
So think of like American planes, like the big American muscle cars, and
this is one. Need history.
Think of Japanese planes like those like light rally cars. So they handle like a dream, but you know, in a collision, it's not gonna survive. T3A is up there. So here we go, Ford Island. We're looking at the battleship row here. So the bombers out in the hangars, out of the hangars, all lined up. Fuck, this fucker's still on me. Alright, let's do something. I'm just gonna let this guy go, but he keeps on pulling me back in. So set to 300 now, so I'm not very used to. Oh, my guy's on him. It's T3As, there's a dive armor, so they're gonna dive onto those ships. Now, I don't wanna mess with any bombers, dive armors or torpedo bombers or any kind of bombers, because they do have rear gunners, which are a lot deadlier than
altitude
pilots.
15, heading 120. Attention! Accomplished. Excellent. That was a gravy run.
Gravy
run. Going
home. So there they go, diving. Diving down. Oh, I see the bomb dropping. Boom, hit. This third guy drop his bomb. No explosion too. Oh. Expect too soon. So that he just got five planes and all five hangars. Just what with one bomb. Damage that battleship down there.
1-5. Heading 030.
Some cruisers and destroyers, whatever. Yeah, I think that was a submarine.
This is one.
Eight history. My guy's taking care of business, and we're just sightseeing here in Pearl Harbor. Here's some more planes out in the wide open. Another submarine, I believe.
Attention, fighters! 5 o'clock.
Who's 5 o'clock? This is our first mission. We are not expected to engage anyone. It's just me and my guy, my wing leader, against hundreds of enemy planes. Well, not hundreds, but sure feels like it. But you know, we don't have any ground resistance, don't have any support planes. So all our battleships are here,
heading
all parked
zero,
nice
three,
in a nice row in the
altitude,
public view.
Two,
you don't want to park your ships like that if you're going to get bombed. You don't want them far spread apart or hidden. So we do have some aircraft carriers, but they're out in the ocean somewhere. They're doing something out in the ocean. So thankfully they were not found and bombed. And there's a lot of plane. Oh, what the hell's going on there? Dropping more bombs. Dropping more bombs. That battleship. So if you ever go to Hawaii, you can actually go visit Ford Island and Pearl Harbor Museum. I've done that. It's neat. You get to see all these airplanes. You get to see P-40 there in the museum. You get to see the A-6M, which are Japanese Zeros. I think they have a flight simulator too, but when I saw it, IL-2 was much better, so I didn't really try it out. That one's cool. Now let's go down, take a closer look. Oh look, torpedoes. Six torpedoes. These B5N, those are torpedo bombers. So they just dropped this, and I missed it. They just dropped this into water. So it's happening zero flying. Yeah. Oh jeez, big explosions. Hundreds of people died just right there. So these six bombers, they dropped the six torpedoes. So that battleship was sunk right there. Well, I don't think it was sunk in this game, but it sank in real life. It's still in the Pearl Harbor, under the water. So you can go visit that. Hundreds of crewmen still buried in the ship to this day. But that's it. It's a very devastating day for the United States and Hawaii. It's a very successful mission as far as the Japanese are concerned. It's a zero by himself for some reason. Hopefully my wing leader went home. I've been flying with my radiator open the whole time. Man, this sucker is by himself. What a treat.
Attention,
I'm also by myself.
1 o'clock.
It's faster than I am. Still a little time compression.
What the hell? Stay with your leader. Stay on course. Heading 300. Altitude.
So we're gonna go home. Those B5Ns, those are bombers. They're slower than I am, but I really don't want to mess with them. So we are flying above some Oahu mountains. My air base is over there somewhere. I have to kind of go through these B5Ns. It's like an excuse for me to take some shots at them. Make sure my canopy is closed so I have some extra cover over my head. And these guys will have rear gunners that are very, very accurate. Flying over this town, 450 kilometers per hour, which is relatively fast. Flying at like 500 meters up in altitude, just kind of low. I'll make one pass at this guy, and I empty out my gun on them. Let's go home if I survive. No slowing down here. Remember, my gun's set to 0.30 now, not 0.50. I'm gonna start firing a little earlier. The guy on the right. He's scared.
Number 2, return to base immediately. Over.
Man. A better armor than I thought. Losing speed. Damn it, can't keep up. Gotta turn around, otherwise I'm gonna get home. This damaged my engine. Almost at him. See, that's why you're flying on a formation. You got guys backing up. So my plane is damaged. I was ready to come back home. They spotted something on me. I don't know who, but they told me to go back home. So I'm going back home. Just follow this coastal line and find my airbase. My canopy here.
Stay with your leader. Stay on course. Heading
300. I have no idea where my leader is.
01. What the hell?
My airbase should be here somewhere. There it is. I think I see it. There. That is my landing strip over here. I'm gonna go ahead and land from the other side. I like to land the same way I took off, so I don't have a landing light. I'll turn on my navigation lights. 100% propeller pitch. Radiator all the way open. Just gonna mess with my throttle to work on my speed. Also my pitch, the yaw and the roll and all that.
Red 2. Clear
for flaps. Oh, I guess I had my combat flaps on all times. Right. My gears. 1, 2, 3. Wheels. Still leaking fuel or something. I don't know. It's my fuel gauge. I still have plenty of fuel. Not leaking that badly. My landing speed is 155 kilometers per hour. Going 180 right now. 170. 160. That's the right speed to land right now. 140, 130. Unless I slow down, my plane will pull to the right, so I'm gonna use the rudder left. Nice easy landing. I remember lowering my combat flaps, but I guess I never raised back up. Still don't know where my wing leader is. Here you go, you see all these P-40s in a nice row here. So if the strafers came, just flew down that way, we would have gotten a bullet in all of these. So I still don't know where my wing leader is. Hopefully he landed here somewhere. P-40s. We're done here. It was a nice 30-minute tour of Oahu Island. We took off, we came down this way. All these planes we saw, they got bombed, destroyed. My wing leader, he shot down all these guys, and we saw all these things blow up, AAAs and static airplanes and ships and everything. Then we came out, we tried to follow a guy, and then we got shot to all hell, so we came back home, followed this coastal line, we found our airbase and I guess North Shore, maybe, I don't know, I forgot. So Billet, he killed two guys. Not sure who killed this guy, but he was shot down. We faced about 15 to 20 Kates, whatever they are, 10 Zigs, 10 Vals. They have all these nicknames for Japanese airplanes. So the Japanese trade attack on this morning, December 7th, 1941, has caused great losses to our Pacific fleet. The Arizona and Oklahoma, are lost. California, Nevada, and West Virginia sunk. Pennsylvania, Tennessee should have two ends, and Maryland are heavily damaged. 188 airplanes have been destroyed, 159 are damaged, 2,400 seamen, pilots, and soldiers are dead, 1,350 wounded. Some heroes could take off, often under heavy fire, set up AAA fire, and pay the Japanese back, but the Japanese lost only 29 aircraft and 5 major submarines. This day of infamy prefigures dark moments for the near future, but the fact is that the Lexington and Enterprise, those are the aircraft carriers, are still at sea, and that our targets, our largest fuel reserves, still intact. America will stand up and fight the Japanese to final victory. So we lost a lot of assets, but some of the biggest assets, the big oil tank and the two aircraft carriers, they're still alive, so America will regroup and start the fight back. So that was our first operation. This is one mission. That was the whole operation. And now we're 7 months later, almost eight months later. Where are we? In New Zealand, New Guinea. All right, so that's where we are. Our next mission.